नमस्कार। आज प्रधानमंत्री के अभिभाषण पर धन्यवाद प्रस्ताव पर चर्चा संपन्न हुई है। पिछले कल लोकसभा में हुई थी और आज राज्यसभा के अंदर कई विषय उठाए गए थे प्रतिपक्ष के द्वारा, चाहे वो सरकार की घोषणाओं के बारे में है, सरकार का ये दावा कि भारत की विकास की सफ़र उसकी बुनियाद 2014 में डाली गई, 2014 के बाद की केवल सब उपलब्धियों का जिक्र, पिछले 5 साल के लेखा जोखा नहीं दिया, जवाबदेही से सरकार भाग रही थी। प्रधानमंत्री जी ने अपने उत्तर में लंबा भाषण तो दिया, व्यंग भी किया, पर उन्होंने उन बुनियादी बातों का उत्तर नहीं दिया जो हमने उठाई थी। ना उन्होंने बेरोजगारी पर कुछ कहा, किसान पर उनका बयान बिल्कुल गुमराह करने वाला था। विपक्ष के नेता ने कभी ये नहीं कहा था कि किसान को आपने पैसा दिया। ये कहना कि चुनाव के दौरान मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट जब लगा हो तब आपने किया, वो चुनाव आयोग से सवालिया निशान लगता है। तो प्रधानमंत्री का बयान सही नहीं था। मैं स्पष्ट शब्दों में कहना चाहता हूँ कि प्रधानमंत्री ने काउंसिल ऑफ स्टेट्स यानी कि राज्यसभा, जो संविधान में संसद का पहला सदन है, और उस सदन में इसकी स्थापना इसलिए की गई थी कि एक तो राज्यों की बात, उनके अधिकार, उस पे बात उठ सके, सुरक्षित रहें, तो साथ साथ कोई भी कानून बिना जांच परख के जल्दबाजी में ना बने। प्रधानमंत्री ने गलत आरोप पूरी राज्यसभा पर लगाया कि पिछले 5 साल में राज्यसभा ने रुकावट डाली है और कई बिल लैप्स हो गए। सरकार को 2004 से 2014 के तमाम आंकड़े हर सत्र के देने चाहिए, किस तरह से राज्यसभा और लोकसभा में व्यवधान था जब भारतीय जनता पार्टी विपक्ष में थी। राज्यसभा का एक दायित्व है कि जब इस सरकार ने एक रास्ता अपनाया, लोकसभा में इनके पास बहुमत और जो महत्वपूर्ण कानून है, संविधान के संशोधन हैं, उनको स्टैंडिंग कमेटी में ना भेजना लोकसभा में, बल्कि सीधा पास कराना, तो राज्यसभा से ये अपेक्षा भी की जाती है, राज्यसभा की संवैधानिक जिम्मेवारी भी यही है कि अगर कोई बिल उसकी स्क्रूटनी नहीं हुई है, कानून बनने से पहले वो की जाए और राज्यसभा उनको सेलेक्ट कमेटी को भेजती है। प्रधानमंत्री क्या चाहते हैं कि लोकसभा से ये मोहर लगवाएं और राज्यसभा बिना सवाल किए एक रबर स्टैंप की तरह से उस पर अपनी स्वीकृति दे, ये संभव नहीं है। दुर्भाग्य की बात है कि जो प्रधानमंत्री भारत के प्रजातंत्र की, जो सबसे बड़ा प्रजातंत्र है दुनिया में, आज ही अपने भाषण में कहा, अगर उसकी बात करते हैं तो प्रजातंत्र की और संसदीय प्रजातंत्र की भावना को उनको स्वीकार करना चाहिए, उस पर उनको आपत्ति नहीं होनी चाहिए। दूसरी बात, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री ने जो सही बयान नहीं दिया, हम इसको उठाएंगे बिजनेस एडवाइजरी कमेटी में भी कल, कि उनको बहुत याचना करनी पड़ी क्योंकि उनको आज बाहर जाना था, कि राज्यसभा में वो समय पर बोल पाए। ये बिल्कुल गलत बयान है। जब ये लोकसभा और राज्यसभा का सत्र, ये संसद का शुरू हुआ, राज्यसभा की बिजनेस एडवाइजरी कमेटी में चेयरमैन ने जो कहा, सरकार की तरफ से प्रस्तावना आई कि 26 तारीख को 2 बजे माननीय प्रधानमंत्री अभिभाषण पे प्रस्ताव का उत्तर देंगे चर्चा का। विपक्ष ने बिना एक प्रश्न किए ये स्पष्ट किया कि जो भी समय प्रधानमंत्री को सुविधा अनुसार हो उसी समय प्रधानमंत्री बोलें और हम उसको स्वीकार करते हैं। हमने यहाँ तक कहा कि हम जानते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री की और कमिटमेंट्स हैं, एक देश के प्रधानमंत्री के नाते उनकी और जिम्मेवारी है, उनको जापान जाना है, इसलिए जो सरकार ने समय कहा है, जो तारीख कही है, हम उसके लिए तैयार हैं। यहाँ तक कि कल राज्यसभा में चर्चा नहीं हो सकती थी क्योंकि एक हमारा जो सदस्य हैं बीजेपी के ही सैनी जी, उनका देहांत हो गया। और दोनों सदनों का ये नियम है कि अगर कोई सिटिंग मेंबर उसका देहांत हो जाता है, मृत्यु हो जाती है, तो सदन की कार्यवाही उस दिन के लिए निलंबित कर दी जाती है। पर क्योंकि प्रधानमंत्री को आज जाना था, इसलिए हमने ये भी माना कि आवश्यक तो है कि एक दिवंगत आत्मा को अपनी सही सदन श्रद्धांजलि दे, पर हमने ये भी स्वीकार कर लिया कि पिछले कल 2 बजे से फिर चर्चा शुरू हो। रात देर तक सदन चलाया ताकि प्रधानमंत्री आज 2 बजे बोल के विदेश रवाना हो सके। सो एज आई सेड, द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डेड टू सम ऑफ द इश्यूज दैट हैव बीन रेज्ड in the discussion in the Rajya Sabha, particularly with regard to the roadmap this government has for reviving the Indian economy. There is a visible slowdown of investments. No new factories are being created. The gross fixed capital formation during the previous 5 years has been stagnant at 2 to 3%. The banks have no money to lend. Industry has no capacity to take credit, which has fallen to at least 5 decades low in proportionate terms. Investment itself has fallen by 7 percentage points. As a result, unemployment has risen to a 45-year high. Prime Minister has not responded to both, that how they propose to bring in both public investment and private investments, how will they ensure the utilization of the existing industrial capacity, one-third of which is idle, what plan of action his government has to create jobs as jobs have been lost in the last few years. I'm referring to the NSSO data, which is confirms at 6.1%. CMI data puts it at much higher. It's also a matter of fact and on record that only in 2018, India lost 11 million jobs. We have not created jobs. There were other issues and concerns expressed about New India. And the Prime Minister, in the President's address, not acknowledging the journey of India which started on 15th August 1947, as I have stated today in the House, the fact that India became a republic on 26th of January 1950, the fact that India was a nuclear power and space power, India had the institutions of excellence, India had established capacities, India had seen the Green Revolution, India had seen the White Revolution, India also saw the revolution of information technology and communications when Shri Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister. So what is the objection to that? Prime Minister did not refer. Even today he was not comfortable even to take the name of India's first Prime Minister and the architect of modern India, and the leader, front-ranking freedom fighter, who spent the maximum time in British prisons. He did respond partially to what we had said about Sardar Patel. We are happy that after 5 years, we forced an acknowledgement in Parliament that Sardar Patel was a Congress leader, he was a Congress president, he was India's first Deputy Prime Minister and India's Home Minister. Prime Minister referred to the statue. More important is to absorb or imbibe the message of Sardar Patel. We thank the Prime Minister that he has invited the Congress Working Committee to meet at Sardar Sarovar, where the Sardar statue is there. Two things. I had pointed out that Sardar Sarovar was Narmada Sarovar. Foundation stone was laid by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in 1961. And it was Jawaharlal Nehru, while laying the foundation stone of Narmada Sarovar, decided to name it as the Sardar Sarovar. Number two, it was Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, since PM said in his speech today that he should have been the first Prime Minister. This means that his office had not informed what I had said today. From when I say, as Deputy Leader of the Opposition, but on behalf of my party, that the Constituent Assembly was meeting until January 1950, and the Constitution of India was promulgated and accepted on the First Republic Day, 26th of January 1950. Sardar Patel was elder in years. I put on record what Sardar Patel had to say himself, which you would have heard, so I'm not going to delve into that. But Sardar Patel, due to his illness, passed away in December 1950. India's first general election was held in April 1952. Prime Minister should at least know that Sardar Patel had left us well before the first election. Only after that a Prime Minister was elected. It was an interim government at the time of independence which continued until the first general election. I hope the Prime Minister dismisses those who have given him inputs for his speech or takes action. Second thing, Prime Minister has chosen to accept partially what we have said. We will be happy to go and visit, because Sardar Patel was a tall leader. But I would request the Prime Minister, let there be transparency and let the history be respected and people be told. Let the Prime Minister and his government accept that Sardar Patel's order of 4th February 1948 banning the RSS, and the reasons that he gave in his handwritten order, followed by a gazette notification, should be put beneath the statue, and also the correspondence between Sardar Patel and Guru Golwalkar of the RSS, and the undertaking that RSS had given to Sardar Patel, that would be a befitting tribute. This is our request to the Prime Minister. Prime Minister has also today insulted the Council of States, the Rajya Sabha. It was unfair and most unfortunate that a Prime Minister has chosen to do so. He has called Rajya Sabha obstructionist, that for 5 years they faced the obstruction, bills were not passed, some bills have lapsed. Prime Minister needs to be reminded that Rajya Sabha, the Council of States, is the first house of Indian Parliament and the permanent house. It has certain constitutional responsibilities and duties. First, BJP's own track record should be made public. Between 2004 and 2014, and in particular between 2009 and 2014, the 5 years preceding the change of the government in 2014, how many bills were stopped? How many constitutional amendments could not be passed? I am specifically now naming. BJP as a political party opposed the constitutional amendment on the land boundary agreement with Bangladesh. They did not allow that constitutional amendment to be passed in Rajya Sabha until the change of the government in 2014. BJP as a party opposed the constitutional amendment throughout on GST, and the charge was led by the then Chief Minister of Gujarat, Shri Narendra Modi ji. Prime Minister should at least have been gracious to thank the Rajya Sabha that it is the Congress as opposition which ensured that these two stalled constitutional amendments were passed. The Bangladesh Land Boundary Agreement constitutional amendment was facilitated to be passed only by the Indian National Congress. The GST constitutional amendment could pass muster in Rajya Sabha only because of the Congress party. Congress has the numbers, Congress had the numbers. Without us, no constitutional amendment would have been passed. So therefore, Prime Minister has been unfair to the opposition and to the Rajya Sabha. Prime Minister and the BJP, they have a root majority in the Lok Sabha. They had it in 2014. So they departed from the established practice of our standing committee system that the bills which are brought before the House is sent for legislative scrutiny before it becomes a law. Because you must appreciate, every law which is made directly impacts the citizens of this country. There is no law which will not affect all of you. So Parliament has to be careful in the enactment of the laws. That's why the system of checks and balances. When Lok Sabha, the bills were brought and passed, Rajya Sabha, the government expected it to be a rubber stamp, which we refused to be. Rajya Sabha is doing its constitutional duty to ensure that every legislation goes through the legislative and parliamentary scrutiny before it is passed to become the law of the land. So Prime Minister should take back this unfair accusation and insult to the Rajya Sabha. It is also not correct that the Rajya Sabha was obstructing in any manner about his departure today and his speaking on time as he had to go abroad. I put it on record in Hindi, but I'll repeat. In the first business advisory committee, the government had said that the Prime Minister has to leave for Japan and requested the opposition that the Prime Minister will speak at 2 o'clock on 26th of June. We accepted it and assured the government and the chairman that let the Prime Minister choose the time of his convenience. Even if he had said that he wants to speak at 12 or at 1, we would have accepted. We also made a fundamental departure yesterday in Rajya Sabha when a sitting member had died. As per the rules, no transaction of business could have taken place. House had to be adjourned for the day. Since PM had to leave today, we accommodated, made a departure, very painful departure, by agreeing for the debate to continue yesterday and sat late into the night to ensure that the Prime Minister is not delayed even by a minute. That's all what I wanted to put on record. Thank you.
We'll take questions.
Haan, koi batao, koi hai to. किसने करी?
सवाल पूछ लिया,
किसने किया चेंज? सरकार ने किया, बीसीसीआई ने। तो बीसीसीआई उसको बता, देखो ऐसा है, ये कोई राजनीतिक विषय थोड़े है, ये तो किस कलर की है, अंग्रेज इंग्लैंड की टीम खेलती है, पाकिस्तान की खेलती है, हिंदुस्तान की खेलती है, बहुत टीमें खेलती है। अगर टीम को कोई कष्ट नहीं है और बीसीसीआई को, हम तो यही कहते हैं कुछ भी डालकर खेलें पर अच्छा खेलें, वर्ल्ड कप जीत के आए बस। धन्यवाद। मैं उस बैठक में नहीं था इसलिए कुछ भी नहीं बोल पाता। मैं जब बैठक में नहीं था ना, मैं तो अभी राज्यसभा की आज की प्रोसीडिंग का बताने आया, मैं उस बैठक में नहीं था, कैसे उत्तर दूं आपको? जब बैठक में नहीं था, मैं तो अभी संसद में चर्चा में था ना, आज स्वयं बोल रहा था, मुझे नहीं मालूम क्या बात हुई। नहीं, अब जवाब गलत नहीं दे सकता, जिस बात की जानकारी ना हो, जानकारी होती तो जरूर टिप्पणी करता।
Judging mob violence and mob cases of mob lynching in, let's say, Jharkhand, where Azad Sahab had said Jharkhand mob lynching ka adda ban gaya hai, and similar cases in Kerala and West Bengal. How would you react to that?
Well, I think there have been very tragic incidents in the state of Jharkhand, which are mob lynching. So, and there are cases of violence coming from other states. When it comes to political violence, we condemn it in all its forms and manifestations. But we also make a distinction between political violence and the lynching of the minorities or the Dalits. Only day before yesterday, there has been a terrible incident in the state of Gujarat, the killing of the Dalits. And before that, the country has seen what happened to the young Muslim boy who just got married 2 months before, and how he was beaten up for 12 hours and how he died. So these are issues. PM should take note of it and take exemplary action. We are happy that Prime Minister has reassured that there will be deterrent action. We believe in Prime Minister's words and assurance. We hope such action will take.